सेकंड सेशन एंड लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन, लेट मी स्टार्ट द विंडोज मशीन। सो एनीवन ट्राइड क्रिएटिंग विंडोज लॉगिन, सीक्वल लॉगिन? इज इट क्लियर? यस्टरडे व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द यस्टरडे क्लास, इज इट क्लियर? What is the prerequisite for creating a Windows login? Yeah, just turn off my fan. What is the prerequisite for creating a Windows login?
Windows user account should be there.
Very good. How to create Windows user? How can we create a Windows user in the Windows level? How to create a Windows user, guys? You don't know the answer, or you are not interested to tell? What is the prerequisite for creating a SQL login? Very good, excellent. Okay, there is no prerequisite.
No, login we have to create.
Yeah, there is no, because only for Windows a prerequisite. Windows level user should be there. Okay, for SQL login there is no prerequisite. Right? How many users we can create for one single login? Very good. Okay,
32,767.
Yeah, 32,767 users we can create for a single login. Right. What is meant by principle?
Accessing the resource.
Yes. Yes, Nagesh.
Accessing the resources are called.
Okay, who is accessing the resources? Okay, usually we can call him as a principal. What are the database level principles in the SQL server?
Users.
Database level. What are the server level principles?
Logins.
Very good. Okay, server level principles are logins. Database level principles are users. What are the database level securables?
Tables.
Good. Okay. Tables are the database level securables. Which resources you are accessing? Those resources are called securables. Usually, which resources the users are going to access? Tables, stored procedures. These are the resources the users are going to be accessing, right? So these resources we are going to call it as a securable. Database is a principal or securable?
Securable.
Okay, logins are going to access the securables, which are databases. So, right. So I hope you all know the difference between a Windows authentication and SQL authentication, and why you don't ask if you choose Windows authentication. Can anyone tell me why you don't ask username and password when you choose Windows authentication?
Install verified password already.
Okay, when?
We already.
Yeah. Already means
already
when?
At Windows level.
Yes, very
Windows
good.
Level.
When you are logging into the Windows machine, already you are a successful verified user in the Windows level itself. When compared to SQL Server authentication, Windows authentication is more secured. Even SQL authentication also rely on Windows authentication only. So as you're already a verified user in the Windows level, so you don't ask the password. Everyone, those who can log into my Windows machine, can access the SQL server?
No, sir.
So what should be there, sir, in case if someone wants to access the SQL server? What should be there? If anyone wants to access my SQL server or connect to my SQL server, what should be there in the SQL server?
They have a login ID and password.
Yes, very good. Okay, a login should be there in the SQL server. Then only other people can connect to the SQL server. By default, a login can connect to the SQL server or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll ask you one question. If you answer anyone, I'll give you a gift. Okay. What are the default users in the database? Don't open the database. Just let me know the answer. What are the default users in the database? Don't open the database. Please be frank. Okay. Don't open the database and don't check it. Just let me know how many of you are remembered that one. Demo. Four database users will be there. Okay. Can anyone tell me four default users? Not demo, Sudarshan.
System administrator.
No. Okay, now you can open the database and now you can tell me the answer. What are the default users we'll get? DBO, database owner, guest, sys, information schema. Okay, sys, not sysadmin. Okay, if you go to any database, if you go to security, if you go to users, DBO, guest, information schema, sys. These are the four default users. For every database, automatically you can see these four database users. In these four database users, DBO will be enabled. By default, DBO is the enabled database user. Remaining all three are disabled state. Okay, so can anyone tell me at least one login, at least one login name, which will come along with the SQL Server installation? What is the main login which will come along with the SQL Server installation? Okay.
Service account?
Not service account, it's a sysadmin, SCA login, SCA. SCA login is very important login, guys. Very, very important. I told you right earlier. So you are going to get this SCA login by default. Of course, you are going to get all the logins itself. This login by default, you will get it. This login also, you will get it. This login, and the service logins, you will get it. With service accounts, it is going to create a logins. Okay. SCA is a default login. Okay. SCA is sysadmin. Okay. It's a powerful login. Usually for all the objects, SCA will be the owner. Okay, so we don't keep any individual persons as a database objects, database owners. Database owners are job owners. We don't keep. Okay, sir, permission, please. Swati, you don't have recording permission. Okay. Yes, Swati, you can record session. Anyone is missing with recording session, recording permissions? Shiva, okay, let me give you the permissions. Yeah, you can record, Siva. Okay. Right. Okay. So in the SQL server, lot of objects will be there, like databases, jobs, and all. For all these objects, usually, who will be the default owner? If you create a database, who will be the default owner of the database?
Master database.
Owner must be a user or login. Okay. Not any database.
DBO, sir.
No, if you create a database, by default, the database owner will be, who will be the database owner? No, no.
SCA?
SCA.
No.
The one who created the database.
Yes, excellent. The one who create the database or the one who create the job. by default, okay, if you see here, right click, new database, okay, you can see default option here, owner, under owner section, you can see default option here, see here, owner. Okay, if I just simply click just okay, might be Flipkart, okay, Flipkart database, let me click okay. Okay, so owner, I didn't change anything, default, it is showing like default, right? Let me click okay, right, now go to the properties of this database. Okay, go to the files page. See, who is the owner of the database? Those who creates the database, by default, he is the owner of the database. Okay, is it recommended?
No.
No. What should be the owner? Who should be the owner of the database or any jobs? SCA. Yes, SCA should be the owner. Okay, so don't keep individual persons as owners of the databases or jobs. Why? Because in case, say for example, okay, if Nanda creates this database, okay, you will get owner as Nanda. Nanda got a good opportunity in another company. Nanda switched the company. Once Nanda went to another organization, his user account or logins will be deleted from the Active Directory. But the owner still shows Nanda only. And the job also still shows Nanda only. Okay, so what happened if it still shows Nanda? If the account is deleted, jobs may fail. Okay, so that's why we don't keep individual users as a database owners or job owners. I'll show you the jobs and all. Once we have a topic automation, in that automation, I'll tell you how to create a job, how to set owner for a job. Okay, so again, we don't entertain keeping individual users as a database owners or job owners. If any owner option is there, that owner, either database owner, job owner, that owner should be by default SCA. No one can delete SCA login. Okay, no one can delete SCA login. Let me close it. So in case if you try to delete it also, you cannot delete SCA login. Okay, it won't allow us to delete SCA login. Okay, drop failed. Cannot use the principles, special principle. Okay, cannot use the special principle SCA. Okay, that means what? You cannot delete SCA login. Okay, so like this, SCA is the permanent login in the SQL server. So for all the objects, usually database owners or job owners, the owners will be SCA only. By default, sysadmin will be the owner, right? So in the last class, we have discussed about the security. We just started security, authentication, authorization principle, securable login, user, okay, right? So on behalf of login, who will be there to help login? Who is going to pull the data on behalf of login? Or who is the helper for the login?
User.
User. Okay. User will be there to help login. Login can never enter into any database. Okay. On behalf of login, the subsequent user will pull the data, will read the data from the database, will write the data to the database. So if someone deletes that particular user, even though the login is having access on that database, that login cannot access the data. Why? Because there is no helper who can help to pull the data for the login. Okay, so user, subsequent user will be there for each and every login, okay, for that particular. That in case, if that particular, imagine in the yesterday's example, we just discussed about the Joshi and Sudarshan, right? So if I gave access on that particular database, Sudarshan is created in the users list. Yesterday, I didn't give access, okay? But I just show you some example, okay? I just click cancel also, right? So in case, okay, now what we are going to do is, now we'll discuss how to create a Windows login. Again, yeah, any questions? Okay, again, okay, just a brief. Yesterday we discussed a lot of things. Just a brief, main things are, okay, logins. We have three types of logins: Windows login, SQL login, group login. For Windows login, in the Windows level, Windows user should be there. We can create Windows user using lusrmgr.msc, local user manager.msc. Just go to the user section. Okay. Permissions, Sudarshan, you don't have permissions. Okay. Right. Okay. You can record the session now. Okay. So go to the users, right click, new user. You can create user like this. So once you just created the user, then only you can create the Windows login in the SQL Server. SQL login, how to create a SQL login or Windows login? Right click, new login. Okay. If it is a SQL login, choose SQL Server authentication. Give the login name, give the strong password. And in case you want to give access on any of the databases, you can select any of the database and you can click OK. Okay, Windows login, you have to choose Windows authentication, but Windows user should be there. Once you create the Windows user, then you can search here. Okay, yesterday we just created Sudarshan, right? Right, so like this, as Sudarshan user is already there. Okay, so that's why we got Sudarshan. So if I click if I type Joshi, okay, so I will get the error. Why? Because Joshi is not created in the Windows level. Okay, we didn't create Joshi. Okay, we have only two users. Okay, one is administrator, second one is service account, third one is your particular Sudarshan user account. Okay, so this is how we have to create a Windows user. Once we create the Windows user, then based on the Windows user name, you can create a Windows login in the SQL Server, right? So we'll discuss about the group login today. It don't take much time, okay? So group login concept is there only for the Windows users, guys. There is no SQL level group login. Group login means only it is possible for Windows login. So now I want to create a group login. So what is the prerequisite for creating group login? Groups, I told you right yesterday, usually in the organization, we don't entertain giving or creating individual logins in the SQL Server, or else Windows people also don't entertain creating an individual user in the Windows level. Yesterday, I gave you the example of if 1,000 servers are there, if Sudarshan wants to access 1,000 servers, Sudarshan has to be created 1,000 times in 1,000 servers, which is not good. Right, to avoid this situation, what we are going to do, we'll take the help of the Active Directory. In the Active Directory, we will have a separate groups. First, Sudarshan will be created as a user in the Active Directory. Once Sudarshan is created, Windows people will add Sudarshan into DBA team. So group will have group policies. DBA group will have group policies. The group, we can set permissions on a group level. So once we added Sudarshan into the DBA group, automatically Sudarshan can log in into all the 1,000 servers. Why? Because that group is having access on all the 1,000 servers. If you are a member of that group, you will also get access automatically. No need to provide a special permissions to you. That is what happened once you go to any company. They are going to create a special login for you, elevated account for you. They will add you into the DBA group. Okay, in the Active Directory, so that whatever SQL database servers are there, don't think you can log into all the servers in the organization. No, you cannot log into all the servers. As per the SQL DBA group policy, on how many servers this group is having access, only those servers you can access without creating your user in those machines. That is the power of the Active Directory. We are going to create Active Directory also. I'll show you how to create a groups in the Active Directory and all. So nothing to worry. So simply, in case you want to create a group login, what should be there? What is the prerequisite?
Users.
Yes, users, then? Users. And, sorry?
Log.
And that is okay. Logins, forget about logins. Once we created the group, then only we can create the login, right? So forget about the logins. So what should be there in the Windows level? Windows group should be there in the Windows level, guys. What is there to think? Simple answer. Okay, we should have users, yes. And again, we have to create group first in the Windows level. Once we created the group, then only we can create a group login in the SQL Server. Clear? Is it clear? Now, only for the practice, I am creating group in the Windows level. Later, once we configured Active Directory, I'll create a group in the Active Directory. But again, this work is belongs to Windows team. We don't have permissions to create users or groups. But for our practice, we have to learn each and everything, right? So that's why we are creating Windows level users and Windows level groups. We don't have access to create Windows level users and Windows level groups in the organization. Clear? Now what I have to create in case I want to create a group login? I want to create a Windows group login now. Okay. What is the prerequisite now?
We have to select the users who will be in that group.
So first of all, we have to create the group or not?
Yes,
no one is telling that answer. Okay, so first of all, we should have a group in the Windows level. Okay, right. So what I'll do, first I'll create users. Okay, I'll choose 2-3 users, then I'll create a group. Okay, and let me go like this. Okay, Chiranjeevi. Right, control A, control C are not required. Okay, I'll give the password. Right, okay, so I'm just unchecking it. Usually in the organization, they don't uncheck it because of security. Create. Next, Balkrishna. Brian Joshi, these are like, these people are our Tollywood heroes, okay? Okay, so I just created 3 users. These 3 people got a job in a company, in the Infosys company, Balakrishna, Nagarjuna, Chiranjeevi got a job as a DBS, okay? So what we are going to do, we'll create a SQL DBA group for them. Okay, go to groups option. Now right click, new group. Okay, I'll create a SQL DBA group. Okay, the group name is SQL DBA, right? So if we create the group, is it enough?
No, we have to add the users.
We have to add the users to the group, right? Where is our group? This is our group, SQL DBA. Double click on it. Click on add button. Okay, you can add all the users at a time. Okay. Okay, so type the complete name. Chiranjeevi. Spelling mistake. Okay, so Balakrishna. Okay, and Nagarjuna. Right, click OK. Now these 3 people are added into the group. Now, OK, next time. OK, so just this group is created, right? Next time, OK, Venkatesh joined in that particular team. OK, Venkatesh got a job in the same company. Next time Venkatesh joined, OK, in the company. So what Windows team will do immediately now, what they are going to do now? A new user joined, okay, in the company as a SQL DBA. What Windows team will do now?
They will add. They will add.
That's it.
Firstly, they create.
First, they will create Venkatesh user here. Okay, right click new user. Okay, Venkatesh. Okay, right. So let me show you one thing before doing that. I don't create user now. Later, once I created a Windows login, then I'll show you the user. Okay. Right. Now, how to create a group login? Nothing is there. There is no group login concept actually. That is also a Windows login only. Instead of giving a single name, you will give the group name. That's it. Okay. Right click, new login, choose Windows authentication as your group is Windows level group, search. Type group name. What is the group name? SQL DB है. Okay, just check names.
SQL DB.
Yes, SQL DB है. Just check names. So you are getting the error. Why we are getting the error? Can anyone tell me? The spelling is correct, right? Tell me. Yeah, you are saying something. Right. So actually what happened is, okay, we have to select this object types. We didn't selected the groups, right? So it is not searching the groups. It is only searching the individual users or service accounts. So choose the groups option now. Then it will search the groups also. Now if you click on check names, now you can see the group name. Bash38SQLDB. Click OK. That's it. Okay. There is no group separate option is not there to create a group login. Simply you will choose Windows authentication. Instead of individual username, you will give the group name. Okay. Right. Now let me click OK. That's it. Group login is created. Now I have a question for all of you. How to identify the difference between a Windows login, a SQL login and a group login? Just by looking itself, you are able to say which one is Windows login, which is a group login, which is a SQL login. How to identify the difference between Windows, SQL and a group login?
For Windows login, that Windows name will be starting with Windows name.
Okay, very good.
Login.
Okay.
And for a SQL login, just it's the name.
Okay, excellent, super.
You can see SQL DB group login. The number of two users is there.
Very
group
good. Login. Excellent, super. Okay, two, three see users. Here. Yeah, here you can see a server with two users. Okay, if you see like this, a server with two users, that is a group login. If you see only a single user with computer name, that is a Windows login. If you see just a name, that is a SQL login. Without computer name, without domain name and all, if you see a name, just a single name, that is a SQL login. Okay, this is how you can easily identify the difference between a SQL login, Windows login and a group login. Right? Fine. Now, see here. Now Venkatesh got a job in that company. Okay. Now what Windows team will do once Venkatesh joined in the company, what Windows team will do? Windows team, first they will create a user for the, okay. Before that, I'll try to log in as a Venkatesh. There is no user of Venkatesh, right? So I cannot log in now. Right click. First I'll create a Venkatesh user. Okay. So now, anything we have to do from SQL side? Venkatesh joined in the company. He got a job as a SQL DBA. Windows team will create a user for Venkatesh. Then what they are going to do? Windows team knows.
They Venkatesh will add in that group.
Yes, very good. Okay, groups, SQL DBA group. Okay, just add Venkatesh. Right, check names, click OK, apply. Now all these four people can connect to my SQL server. Okay, nothing we are going to do from SQL DBA side. Nothing for Venkatesh. For Venkatesh, we are not going to do anything from SQL DBA side. DBS won't do anything. Simply Venkatesh is a member of group, right? SQL DBA group, right? As SQL DBA is already there, okay? As SQL DBA is already there, as SQL DBA group is already there, who are the members of this SQL DBA group in the Windows level? All users can connect to my SQL server. Nothing can be done from the SQL DBA side. In case you want to check who are the users are there, there is a query for that. I'll show you. Okay, who are the members of the a Windows group? You can easily find out the members of a Windows group. Usually one command, okay, what is that command? xp_login_info. Okay, just drag your group name, which group you want to find out, comma members. Okay, sometimes you'll get the answer, sometimes it won't throw, it will throw error. Okay, why? Because sometimes we don't have permission. See here, it is showing Venkatesh name, right? Right now, nothing to do from the SQL DBA side. Venkatesh what are all the permissions are having for these three users, Venkatesh also can log into all the database servers as a admin. As of now, I didn't give any permissions for that group, but again, what are the group permissions are there? Okay, they can easily log into the servers, okay, and they can complete their requirements and all. So this is the advantage of the group login. Usually in the organization, we will encourage only group logins. We don't encourage individual logins. Again, creating individual login, giving permissions separately is not a good option. And if 5,000 users are connecting to the database, 5,000 logins will be there, which is not good, right? Every employee belongs to a group, okay? Every employee, definitely he should belongs to a group. Okay, so that's why we don't encourage individual logins. In case if one user is only asking for permissions, what we will do, you know, we'll route him to the Windows team. Hey user, please ask Windows team to create a AD group for you. Windows team will create a AD group for that single user. Then we'll create a group login. Even though in that group only one user is there, that is not an issue. Next time some other people can add easily. Our maintenance will be less in that case. If it is individual logins and all, headache will be there, giving permissions, again removing permissions, a lot of headaches will be there. So we don't encourage individual logins. Okay, the meeting is going to close now. Let me reopen the meeting. Please join with the same link.